Well, g'day there. It's been an interesting few weeks out in the electorate. I've had the Prime Minister coming from Waipawa down to, down to Woodville, really, including stop-offs in Norsewood and in Dannevirke. And then we've had Joe Goodhue in Dannevirke last week. And next Friday, I've got Chester Burrows coming over to open the Masterton Court. Boy, that's taken a few months. Well, 6 months this year and most of last. 18 months, because we thought it was an earthquake risk. Well, at least stuff's moving forward, and I think Holmes Construction will have done an excellent job. Good Greytown company, that. So why did I take the PM into the North electorate? He hadn't been there for 8 years. In fact, in Dannevirke, they tell me there hadn't been a Prime Minister visit Dannevirke since about 1981. That was R.D. Muldoon, who opened the Aringi Freezing Works, subsequently closed. So I took him to Norsewood and to the Great Kiwi Sock Company, because that's a really good news story. You might remember about 4 years ago, it bottomed up when some directors based in Wellington took over and stripped the marketing side of it out and then put the company into receivership. I'm really pleased to tell you that there are now 17 employees in that company, and they're making socks and they're exporting them and selling them all through New Zealand, a success story. And they've just retooled with world leading edge knitting machines out of Italy. Then we went down to Dannevirke to meet with about 140, 150 members of the Chamber of Commerce. And then I took the PM out to Metalform, because that's a company that's been doing really well, about 52, 54 employees in Dannevirke. And they do things like exporting wheelchairs that they design locally, retail $25,000 American dollars each, and they're shipping them out by the container load. And they're into manufacturing a lot of innovative agricultural equipment. From there, I took them down to Aringi because, again, Aringi was the failed meatworks 3 years ago, making great headlines. And now it's been turned into an industrial park, more than 90 employees over a range of companies there. What was the common factor? The common factor was Scanpower. Interesting. Scanpower is a community trust run, but private sector driven electric power supplier. They're the second smallest in the country, about 6,800 customers. But interesting arrangement in that the trustees elected by the community on behalf of the customers appoint commercial directors. And I feel this has got a big lesson for those of us in the south of the electorate, where we've got the Masterton Trustlands Trust, Masterton Licensing Trust owns all the houses, and we've got the Greytown Lands Trust. And I really think that in those cases, we're electing trustees to act as directors, and they don't always, and those people don't always bring good business skills to the businesses. And so I think that if we're trying to think about how can we get bigger gains for the community, I quite like the Scanpower model, where trustees appoint commercial directors, people with proven business experience, and I think that way we might lift the performance of those three southern trusts. Just a thought. What else has been going on? Well, there's been some really good work going on in Dannevirke, where iwi and the community have come together to form up an integrated family health centre. And I particularly praise Sharon Wards for the great work that she has done over many years looking after the health in an innovative way of that Dannevirke community. She's been behind the community hospital. She was behind making sure services came into that community when the Manawatu Health Board pulled out. I think she's done a fantastic job, and this is just icing on a cake, and it's really good to see all elements of the Dannevirke community working well on that issue. And then, as I said before, next week I've got Chester across and we're going to be opening the Masterton Courthouse. Otherwise, the electorate seems to me to be in pretty good shape. The irrigation projects both in the north and in the south seem to be moving forward. Some concern in the Mangatiriri Valley from people who fear that if a dam was constructed there, it was going to damage their homes. Not sure if that's going to be the case. So on behalf of all of us, I would really like to congratulate some residents of the electorate. First of all, down on the bottom, Martinborough, David Kershaw, for the award that he got for services to business and the community, really well deserved. To Eva Wright, who was recognised in Dannyburg for her work in the community. For Herbert Jones in Ekitahuna, and his work in conservation and music. And for Penny Mast at Mason in Waipakarau for the tremendous work that she does for the Red Cross. Congratulations to each of you on the good work that you do on behalf of the community, and your awards in the Queen's Honours List this year was richly deserved.